Well, thankfully my hand's great. I have three of my four colors of mana, plenty of early defense. In a perfect world, I wouldn't trade off my Heir of the Wilds early, save it for like, the Feral Khrushchak or something bigger that I can trade for. But the prospect of getting in for two damage is kind of appealing here. I mean, he's almost definitely going to play a Dragon Bell Monk, and then I'm almost definitely not going to attack, but definitely not attacking with Archer's Parapet if I cast that, so. And maybe my opponent has an awkward hand. But that can be a little scary too, because maybe it means he kept it because of having a single extremely powerful rare card in hand. But maybe I'm being paranoid, we'll see. If he attacks, I'm definitely just going to morph the flock and block Kirin. What else did I put Monastery Flock in my deck for? Ooh, pretty good draw. I don't know why I didn't play Pinewalker first. That was pretty awful play. Not only did I miss a point of damage, but I allowed my opponent to block if he decided that was the right move. That was bad. See, I mean, I play so many long defensive games with this deck, I forget how to attack. And with Archer's Parapet and close race, you never know when one damage can make a very big difference. So I feel safe attacking with both my creatures here. If he tries to make some kind of double block, I have Grim Contest in the bank. Now, I think I just want to wait and see what happens. The Sultai Flayer is not particularly threatening. It can't get through my 05 blockers, and the only thing it would be able to do is double block Pinewalker eventually, in which case I can maybe blow him out with Grim Contest. This game is dissimilar from the first game in that my life total is not in danger, and I really just want to protect against my opponent having like something. A single super powerful card that dominates the game. Now, I'm just not even going to bother attacking this turn. I don't want to attack into open mana. I don't want to give him 4 life off the Sultai Flayer. And I'm going to win the race with Archer's Parapet if nothing happens, so. Plus, I did draw the Beastmaster, which is even more reason to want to stall the board. Right, that guy's lifelink, which is definitely relevant here. But if I'm just going to block and eat it with Pinewalker, then that's totally fine. Nope, not going to let that happen. So I don't want to attack the Pine Walker into a possible double block. It's not that bad, though. I can see just tapping out for Treasure Cruise here. You know what? Let me take the aggressive approach here. I like trading off creatures. I mean, this attack forces us to trade off creatures, which, generally speaking, means less can go wrong. You know, overrun effects or a surprise island and icy blast. Like, with fewer creatures on the table, it's better for me. Now I can Treasure Cruise for 6 mana, which I think I want to do. Because if I draw like a tapped white land, that's pretty good for me. Monastery Flock, definitely MVP of this game. And here you're seeing the power of Abzan Beastmaster. Remember, this was my second pick of the draft. I really, really like this card quite a lot. Alright. Access to 7 mana. I would like to play Sandstep Citadel this turn. I don't see much reason to cast Bitter Revelation. Got everything I need right here, so... play the Citadel, play a face down card, play my banner. Sure, I'm glad he's going after the Beastmaster. I was a little bit scared at the prospect of him going after Monastery Flock. But drawing cards is not, you know, I have enough cards this game. The way I would lose is my life total unexpectedly dropping to 0. I don't think I'm going to flood out and lose. I don't mind losing the Beastmaster. Two, three, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12 mana. So I guess I cast Bitter Revelation first. Although maybe not. Maybe like those cards that I see are just not as valuable as the 2 life. Plus, I do want to use Archer's Parapet every turn. when possible. I think this is a bluff attack. Not for sure, but I think I'm just going to block. Okay. I'm still okay with this. I forgot to respond with my archer's parapet, but thankfully it's loss of life, not damage. So channel harm doesn't apply. One, two, three, four, eight, nine, ten mana, so I'll just cast this face up. Alright, so that's the last card in my opponent's hand, which means Archer's Parapets are close to lethal. I think I literally just sit here and use Archer's Parapet to win the game. It's my best move. Yep, just going to pass the turn again. The slow and painful death. Death by Archer's Parapet. If he drew a warrior, it gives him one more turn because of the Mardu Woe Reaper's ability. What's he killing? My flyer? Alright, I don't think I care about that. He can't kill me, and the Archer's Parapets are still going to be lethal. So I get to block all of the ground creatures. Block. Block. Chump block. 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 So it looks like, unless I'm missing something, I've won my first draft, 3-0, and I get to advance to the second draft of this 64-player event. So I hope you'll stay tuned, and hopefully I have equal amount of success in the next draft.